الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، today I choose the hadith because yesterday we talked about the rahmah, the mercy, and how the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was merciful and how he asked us to be merciful to each other. Today I choose the hadith that changed one of the Sahaba to be the most merciful one. After a life he spent in doing something really bad. So this hadith reported by Abu Dharr al-Ghafari radiyallahu ta'ala an. Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, one of the greatest Sahaba. They said he was the fourth or the fifth Muslim. So he was the fourth or the fifth one to declare his Islam. He is one of the earliest Muslim. Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was outside Mecca. In the Bedouin area, which is very close to the route of the caravans. And his tribe, their job is stealing the caravans, doing nothing else. They just wait to the caravans when it comes and they steal people. That's how they making live. They live of stealing people. So that's how he spent his life. He's like spent his life doing this job.
Felix.
Just like stealing violence. People.
Violence. Stealing from
people. Yes. Stealing from people. That's it. That's what he did in his life. So subhanAllah, he said, I was worship Allah before I met the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, he said, once I left my luggage, I was worshipping the idol, and I left my luggage with the idol, and I asked him to protect my stuff. And I went, and I came back, and I found the fox urinate on the face of the idol. And I said, like, which God that the fox can pee on his face and he can't even protect himself? He said, A Rabb yabul al-thu'luban bi ra'sihi. Subhanallah. He said, like, a God that the fox pee on his face? Subhanallah. So he said, from that time I was worship Allah, but I don't know who was I worship. Until a day my brother came to me and he said, there is one guy, he worship the same God that you worship. He said, then I went to Mecca and I asked for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Ali ibn Abi Talib led him to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he made it to Islam right away. He knew that's the right thing. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him to hide his Islam and go to his people and invite them for Islam, to Islam. But what he said, no, by Allah I will go in front everyone, I will declare my Islam. And he went and he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. So all people of Quraysh, they gathered and they started beat him up. They hurt him so bad until the Abbas came and he said, like, you almost killed the guy, and your caravan just go close to his people. You can't pass the way if you kill him. So they left him. So the only reason that he didn't get killed at that day, because his people will take revenge for him. So he went to his people and he said, half of my tribe, they believed in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the other half, they believed, but after a while. So Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, or Jundub bin Junadah, his name Jundub bin Junadah, radiallahu ta'ala an, he was the fifth Sahabi. And they said he was the head of Zuhd. And the Zuhd is leaving the dunya and focusing on Akhirah. He used to get the money and take whatever can support him for the year and spend everything else. He buy a food which is enough for the whole year, and whatever he earned after, he gave it away. And this is a guy who used to steal people. SubhanAllah. How the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has changed this guy. The reason that I'm talking about the Sahabi, we know we're always talking about the Sahaba, the reporter of the Hadith. But now if we read the Hadith, we will think, oh, maybe this is a regular person, but he's not. He's one of the greatest Sahaba. But everyone do mistakes. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam correcting them. So Abu Dharr al-Ghafari radiyallahu ta'ala an, he believed in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Half of his tribe, they believed after him. He starts with his brother, his mother, and then the rest of the tribe. And they used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their land until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Al-Madinah, and then they followed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then he stayed with the Prophet and he went with him to many of the ghazawat. So the hadith by the way, he passed away on the 32nd of Hijrah, the year 32nd of the Hijrah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about him, he will die alone and he will be raised alone. And the reason of this hadith, subhanallah, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Ghazwat Tabuk, a lot of munafiqeen, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was fighting very big armies, so a lot of like munafiqeen, they don't follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because they were scared. So they said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, oh, this one, he didn't come with us. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, if he's good, he will follow us. If it's not, we don't need him. But they came to him and they said, Abu Dharr is not here. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say anything. And then what happened with him, his camel a little bit become slow. So he afraid he will miss the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the army. So he get all the stuff from the camel, put it on his back, and run to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they saw, the army saw a man like running from far distance. So they said, there is someone. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam right away said, Kun Abu Dharr, be Abu Dharr, because he really liked him. And he came. And he said, he walk alone, he will die alone, and he will raise alone. SubhanAllah. And he died alone. Ibn Mas'ud said, while he's traveling outside in Medina, he passed away, and he asked his wife, because he was only with his wife, to put him on the way, because he wants someone to pray on him. She said, just put me on the way, maybe someone will come. So Ibn Mas'ud himself came with a lot of people from Kufa, and he saw him and he buried him himself and prayed on him, subhanAllah. And he mentioned the hadith, said the Prophet ﷺ said this, And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the truth. He died alone. So subhanAllah. So the hadith is that Abu Dharr al-Ghafari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu قال سابقت رجلا فعيرته بأمه فقال لي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا ذر أعيرته بأمه إنك امرئ فيك جاهلية إخوانكم خولكم جعلهم الله تحت أيديكم فمن كان أخوه تحت يده فليطعمه مما يأكل وليلبسه مما يلبس ولا تكلفوهم ما يغلبهم فإن كلفتموهم فأعينوهم. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Dharr said that he insulted or abused a man by calling his mother with the bad names. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to me, O Abu Dharr, did you abuse him by calling his mother with the bad names? You still have some characteristics of ignorance. Your slaves are your brothers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put them under your command. So whoever has a brother under his command should feed him from what he eats and should dress him of that which he dresses. Do not ask them, the slaves, to do things beyond their capacity. And if you do so, then help them. This is the hadith. And the reason that Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala mentioned this hadith, that Al-Ma'rur bin Suwayd, one of the tabi'een, he saw Abu Dharr al-Ghafari wearing hulla. And the hulla is just like a suit, two pieces of clothes. And he saw his slave wearing the same thing. In another narration, he's wearing one piece and the slave wearing the other. But it's the same suit. And usually if you have a slave, you don't like let him wear the same. There is the Sayyid, the owner, and there is the slave. And the slave usually wear whatever you have extra. You give him like whatever you have. But the honorable person, he will wear very good clothes. So he was like surprised. He said, if you like take it, it's like a very good suit. Why you give it to the slave? So he said, once I insult a man and his mother was not an Arab. She was a slave. And he just insult him by calling him, they said he called him Ibn Sauda, which is the son of the black. But this is not really in the hadith, it's from another narration, it's not really confirmed, but still it gives us how he used to act. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew about what he said, you still have something from the jahiliyyah, from the old time in your heart. You have to clear it. That's why he gave the good clothes to his slave. Because before, he was thinking he's the Sayyid, he's the honorable person, and everyone is like under his command. Now he's changed. This is with the mercy of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the hearts of Muslimin from being ignorant and arrogant to be very merciful and very good. So he has this slave under his command, he let him dress from the same clothes that he wear. And then he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِخْوَانُكُمْ خَوَلُكُمْ. It means from, you know when you say خَوَّلْت فُلَان, it means like I gave him the authority. Like these slaves, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are your brothers. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them under your command. So when you deal with them with good. Feed them good. From the same food that you eat. And if you dress them from the same clothes that you wear. And don't ask them to do something hard. They can't do it. And if you give them a very hard command, help them. There is no shame of helping them. And this is the Prophet ﷺ asked them to be good to the slaves. Even though at that time, the slaves, it's something you own. It's just like being, at that time, being good to something, it's belong to you. You don't have to. They don't even think about it in Jahiliyyah. So the Prophet ﷺ asked them to be good to the slaves. And he said, they are your brothers. And they work with the authority that you give them. So it just there is nothing like make you better than them. Nothing. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them under your command. And they work with your authority. That's it. It doesn't mean you are better than them. Maybe as in Islam they are better than you. You don't know. Because the how you put people in level with the taqwa, with fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with how good deeds they offer. This is the only thing. So this hadith can show us how this man changed from a one waiting for the caravans to steal for living to a man let his slave wearing from the same clothes. Even at that time, even the Muslims were wondering why he did this. So how the Islam changed Abu Dharr from this bad person to this good person. A one who doesn't keep any money in his house except what can support him for living, for him and his wife and his children. So subhanAllah, when we look to it, we would think it's not something normal. But this is the Sahaba, when they saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as example in front of them, they can see it. They can see it themselves. It's really affect them in a way that they change themselves. Now, when in these days, when we see everyone running after the money, running after the desires in this life, we don't see these examples anymore. And it's always like pushed us to do sometimes things we don't really want. There is a lot of people, they don't like this kind of house or car, but they do it because people, they think, you are rich if you have this kind of car or this kind of house. They will bring this designer to do his house or to do his clothes. But they don't like it. But they do it because people think it's cool and it's you are rich if you do it. But we don't have the examples of the Sahaba. We should actually put these examples in front of our eyes. To look to it, to see how they dealt with people, how much iman they have in their hearts, how much belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine when he passed away, he said to his wife, don't do it, just put me on the road, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send someone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent someone with a lot of group. In the area there is no one to pray on him and to bury him. Wallahi, we need this kinds of iman these days. And we need these examples to look to it, to keep it in front of our eyes. Otherwise, we will keep looking outside and we'll see nothing except people following their desires, following this the dunya. And then they will reach nothing, and they will start doing things they don't even like, they don't want, just to make people happy or to try to find the happiness. And the happiness is just simple. Just live the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us to worship, and He has set the rule in this life. If you follow it, you will be the happiest person on earth. That's it. SubhanAllah. So I have choose this hadith because yesterday we talked about how Islam is the religion that brings all the mercy to the life of Arab, and how he changed people from bad to good. So any questions? Ali? No questions today? Okay. Jazakumullah khair, barakallah.